The Karamoja police spokesperson, Mike Longole, explains that the unfortunate incident happened as Uganda Wildlife Authority officials who were searching for a lost drone were attacked by unidentified warriors.
Getting the drone as they were coming back from where they got the drone, as they were coming back to the base at Pianaupe, Jam Reserve, they were attacked by some unknown warriors whom we suspect to be the Pokot. Unfortunately, they shot at our forces, that is the war staff, and then as this one fired back at them, they decided to take off. As they were taking off, one of them failed to run and he was arrested. That's when now we confirmed that these people are the Pokot, because one of them is in our custody.
The alleged that the Pokot warriors who were grazing in the game reserve were engaged in a fire exchange as security intervened to rescue the UWA officials, and a 10-year-old boy was shot in the thigh and is currently admitted. According to the Karamoja police spokesperson, despite the incident, the disarmament exercise was successful. He thanked local leaders for mobilizing residents to surrender their guns.
The guns are still there because on this Pokot, they have different places of abode. They can reside in Amdak. At times they cross to Kenya side. So we find that it is really very difficult. And for us, we cannot carry out operations in the Kenyan side. It's the Kenyan people to carry the operation. I know the guns come from across. Then they come and do atrocities in Uganda. Then they return back. But most of the Pokot we see around, even in the bushes, they are not harmed. It is just a few individuals who still have guns.
Investigations into the matter are currently ongoing as one suspect was arrested and is currently in police custody under interrogation.
The one who were arrested is in our custody and will help us in further investigations. It's really unfortunate that the Pokot have continued attacking forces, and we warn them that they should stop.
Report compiled by Agnes Najuma for the news.